And a Toowoomba man who lost his wife and son in the city's flash flood has declared war on the Premier over the slow distribution of her disaster funds. John Tyson says his sad story has been used for political gain and he's had enough.
His wife and son killed in the floods, John Tyson battles feelings of unimaginable loss, but there's another fight on his hands.
If I could look Anna in the face and ask her something, I don't think I'd take the time out of me day.
He asked mourners at the Rice funeral not to bring flowers, to donate to the Premier's disaster appeal instead. Now he regrets it.
They've grand stood on my wife and child's death. That's how I feel. Well, that's fact.
4 months after the floods, 3 months after Cyclone Yasi, 70 of the $259 million in the appeal has made it to the victims, the Premier defending the process.
There are many people who are still finalising their applications.
But their applications, victims say, are complicated.
What makes a passport look like a preschool application?
The means tests, unattainable, the red tape, suffocating.
Before with Larry it was a much quicker response.
Their homes destroyed, Yasi victims are renting in community housing. Even getting a look-in for the appeal requires two quotes from builders.
And I don't think that the public who donated would want me to be giving $80,000 grants to people who, for example, might only have $10,000 worth of damage.
Though John Tyson has perhaps one of the most gut-wrenching stories from the floods, he feels a personal responsibility to speak up for others.
I think if we've got to be the voice for the people that can't quite keep it together for long enough to do that, well, I don't want to do that, but I'm quite prepared to be one of the people. Yes, no worries at all.
He wants the money returned to those who donated it so they themselves can hand it on. Renee Henry, 10 News.